Hi everybody, today is February 5th, 2013. Now this is a real interesting article with great information. Maoists vow to continue putting bombs in dead bodies. I thought, well, who the heck is the Maoists? Mao, you think of China. But it also has ties with the Russian Communist Party. And it's a group that was founded in 2004 through a merger of two different groups, the People's War and the Maoist Communist Center. So we got China and Russia affiliated groups which are doing acts of terror in India to overthrow the India government. Supposedly they say they're fighting for the right of the tribes in the forest belt around central India. The ideology it says here is Marxism and Leninism. That's Russian. And it says there's between 10 and 20,000 people that belong to this group. And for those of you who don't know history, back during the Second World War, it was common to booby-trap dead bodies. The article reads what could turn out to be a huge worry for the Home Ministry and security forces dealing with Naxals and Maoists have declared that they will continue with the tactic of planting bombs in the bodies of killed security personnel like they did in Lakhdar and Jardin recently. In a written statement dated January 16th on behalf of the Bihar Jardin North Chahikitsar Special Area Military Commission of the PLGA CPI. The spokesperson, Tofan, said that since the attacks by security forces on Maoists did not follow any rules of war, they would also go beyond the rules. While the media and the government have turned the strategy to plant bombs inside dead bodies of security personnel inhuman, it has not looked at the inhuman manner in which state forces have been killing and attacking the Maoists, the spokesman said. The statement also talked about the inhuman manner in which dead Maoists were treated by the security force during encounters and claimed that often they did not even inform the families of the dead and return the bodies to them. On planting bombs in the body of a Jawan, the CPA Maoist statement said, "We have no qualms in admitting that warriors of PLGA had put a time bomb in his abdomen. PLGA warriors, however, have never tortured a Jawan who is alive. In fact, we have treated arrested Jawans as prisoners of war and even released them. If putting a bomb in a dead body is disrespectful of the dead, then it is a crime committed by doctors who conduct post-mortem. The truth is, the sole aim of planting a bomb in the Jawa's abdomen was to cause maximum damage to the hostile center forces, to oppose the atrocities by the central forces." And it names three different areas. "We will continue to do this, plant bombs in dead bodies." The statement added that the PLGA wants to make it clear that the bombs planted in the Jawa's body were a simple circuit time bomb, which was set in such a way that it would explode either at the spot or when the dead body was taken away. "Doctors were not our targets, as it has been made out to be. It was an ordinary circuit that got defused because water seeped into it," it says. Some old tricks of war being used again today. Interesting. You learn something new every day about the insanity of war. Alright, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.